Welcome back. You're with Tangata Pasifika. It's been nearly 6 weeks now since the Christchurch earthquake, and while life goes on for locals, there's a realisation that things in the Garden City will never be the same again.
And that's firmly on the minds of many of our people as they slowly start making their way back to Christchurch. John Utanga has the story.
A kindergarten in Aranui and Cook Islander Poi Kairua is heading back to work. It's her first day back since the earthquake struck over a month ago.
Coming back on board, it's lovely to see the children. They've all said, you know, I've missed you, and it's nice to see the staff and back to familiar grounds. The families are slowly, you know, leaving their doors and bringing their children back into kindy. But I think that might take some time.
A day earlier, Poi was in Ashburton, about a 40-minute drive south of Christchurch. It's where many Cook Islands families fled after the quake. Poi, her husband and their five children stayed with relatives.
The Ashburton crowd, the Cook Island side is like practically like the Christchurch, you know, the Christchurch Cook Islanders with open arms, and they know what we went through. And
I think it gave us the opportunity to sort of rest and not so be worried about whether the children were a bit apprehensive of, you know, where's the next one coming from.
For Ashburton's Cook Islands community, a helping hand was the least they could do.
It's been quite awesome, you know, having the family. We don't moan or anything. Our arms are opened. We all get along with each other.
Meanwhile, back in Christchurch, life goes on. The city's CBD copped the worst of the quake, but so did the city's eastern suburbs. A month on and things are not moving as quickly as many here hoped.
We were putting it in perspective where the biggest need was in Christchurch, and it was in the CBD, because lives had been lost. But as time has gone by, we have felt sometimes that infrastructure has taken a little bit longer to get to the eastern suburbs in terms of the water, the waterworks, the power. We never got power here until day 15. We still don't have water on now, and it's day 30.
I think the main concern is water, the sewage, and quite sometimes power comes on and off, and I think that's what our community is sort of stressed.
Another big problem in this area is housing, as many homes are unlivable. With winter fast approaching, it could become a big problem.
The biggest need is that we need accommodation that can actually be lived in. We work quite closely with Housing New Zealand, and they know they've got a huge responsibility in here because there's a big, well, Housing New Zealand's our biggest landlord here in Aranui.
I'm in the suburb of Bexley in Christchurch's east, one of the areas worst affected by the earthquake. Now right here is the home of the Vehekite family. In the days after the quake, they grabbed their kids, grabbed the essentials and left. A month on, the house still stands empty and the family show no signs of wanting to return.
We met Leslie Vehekite and her family soon after the earthquake. They were living with other Tongan families in their church in Spraydon. A month on, Leslie and many others are still here.
We try to go home every second day just to check, but every time we go back, there's a new damage to the house, and the first damage on the 22nd is even getting worse. So yeah, I don't feel safe going back home. Yeah, especially I've got young children.
And the kids are still enjoying it here?
Yeah, they love it here. I try to encourage them to go back home, but no, they'd rather stay here.
Leslie says she's been in touch with Housing New Zealand about a new home, but understands how busy they must be.
I'm quite lucky that we've got the church to stay here, and the minister has been very kind. I feel more comfortable being here.
But the minister is concerned that so many of his flock have chosen to stay, especially with winter on the way.
The actual idea we got is trying to help people go back to their house and try and do what they can and live in their house when the winter comes. Because we can't afford to keep them here during that time. And it's a big issue for us. And we'll try to do our best, whatever we can do.
For Pacific people who can't get support, a new initiative has been set up to help. Based in Aranui, it's called the Pacific Hub, a one-stop shop for people needing urgent help, thanks to the Ministry of Pacific Islands Affairs and local Pasifika community groups and service providers.
In the last week, we have had three mobile services, two out in Hornby, one at Ifakasa in Woolston, only on Saturday. And through that, we've had nearly 1,000 families that have been helped just in the last week. So I think the need is absolutely there.
The hub will stay open until the middle of April. By then it's hoped many of those who have left town will be back.
We've got a few of our people who are away now, but I think they need time off. They need to be relaxed and feel comfortable at a place where it's not shaken, because aftershocks are still happening. But I haven't heard any news or any story from our parishioners who went away saying that they're not coming back.
Meanwhile, many of those Cook Islanders in Ashburton are in two minds about whether to return to Christchurch.
Yes, we'll be sticking around Ashburton for a while. It's just because there's still rumours going around there is still a big one that's going to hit Christchurch. But whenever that is, we don't know.
For the Kairua family, the kids will stay in Ashburton until the end of school term. Then they're thinking of leaving Canterbury for Australia or the islands.
Wouldn't that be a dream to go back to Rarotonga? It might not be a reality. But then we never know. I mean, you know, home is always home. And Christchurch is a place that we've sort of made it our home.
And if you'd like to get help from the Pacific Hub in Christchurch, phone them on 03 964 9064 or text them on 022 696 1311.
Time now for community notices with Tell Me by Erica featuring Jay Williams. You're the first one to make me feel like this. And this is one opportunity that I can miss no more. Oh, you wanna know the deal? You were wondering if the words I'm saying are for real. Cause you got more appeal than any man in this whole world.
Just after the break, football, a Vanuatu club on the rise.
And Vince Harder drops by for a chat and a jam. Mm-hmm, yeah.